Okay, let's start. Okay, again, relation and function. A relation is any set of ordered pairs. The set of all first elements of the ordered pairs is called the domain of the relation, and the set of all second elements is called the range. While a function is a relation or rule of correspondence between two elements, the domain and range, such that each element in the domain corresponds to exactly one element in the range. Kaya bawal maulit. Okay? So to further understand function, let's try this. Okay? Ordered pairs. Unahin natin ang example ay ordered pairs. A, B, C, D are relations. And these are ordered pairs. Which relations are functions? A is a function. B is a function. C is not a function. Why? Because 1 is to 0 and then negative 1 is to 0 again. So naulit siya. Therefore, this is not a function. While D is also not a function. Why? Because C is to D and then A is to D. Hindi rin siya function. How about if we're given a table of values? Kanina, we're given ordered pairs. This time, table of values. Which relations are functions? A, B, or C? Let's try letter A.
A.
Okay, A is a
function.
Function. Yes, correct. It's a function. Kasi walang naulit. Okay, walang naulit yes. Dito sa X papunta kay Y. How about B?
Not a function.
Not function.
Functions.
B is not a function.
Not a function.
Function.
Functions po.
Functions.
Not a
function. Not a function.
Not a function.
Not a function po.
It is not a function kasi si 1 kay negative 2 na, si 2 kay negative 2 pa. May naulit. So this is not a function. How about C?
Function.
Not a 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 function.
Bakit not a function?
Not a function.
Function po. Naulit po yung negative.
Naulit po yung negative.
Okay. Negative 1 corresponds to 2 values. 4 and 1. Okay? The negative 1, o itong negative 1, no, naulit siya para kay 4 at saka kay 1. Nakuha ba? Class, alam ko nalilito kayo. Okay, yung iba nalilito pa. Pero sige, kanina example natin ordered pairs. Ito table of values. Tingnan natin kapag diagram. Okay, kapag diagram na. Okay? It's A, B, C. These are relations. Which are functions? A is to X. B is to Y. C is to Y. Is A a function?
Not a function.
Not a function. Not a function.
Sir, si sir.
Ha?
Not a function.
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 Not
po, sir.
How about B?
Not din po.
Not a function.
Not in the function po.
Not
a function.
B is function. Not a function.
Yes, not a function.
B is a mere relation, but not function, because there is a domain that corresponds to more than one range. Okay, look at this. X, tapos A and B. And letter C, how about C?
Function.
Function.
Kasi si Jana for A, Maya for Ken, Donna is
function.
Function.
Okay, good. Ngayon, we're given diagram. Nakuha nyo na siya. Last one will be a graph. Okay? Tingnan natin yung graph. Paano mag-identify if a graph is a function or not? So a relation between two sets of numbers can be illustrated by graph in the Cartesian plane. And that a function passes the vertical line test or the VLT. Vertical line test. So vertical, patayo. A graph of a relation is a function if any vertical line drawn passing through the graph intersects it at exactly one point. Tingnan natin to. Using a vertical line test, ibig sabihin magdo-drawing ka ng vertical line sa graph mo and identify which of the following is a function. Kapag class, ang vertical line ninyo dumikit ang dalawang point, hindi na siya function. So let's try. Look at my cursor. For example, in this graph, I will draw a vertical line. For example, ito, vertical line. Oops, ilang point tumama?
One lang po.
One lang, diba? Dito lang. How about kunyari, dito ko nilagay?
Isa lang.
Kapag na-drawing ka ng vertical line dyan sa graph mo at isang point lang tumama, therefore, this graph is a function. Okay, this is a function. Letter B, tingnan natin. Magdo-drawing ako dito sa bandan dito ng vertical line. Ilang dalawa points ang tinamaan
ng vertical?
Dalawa po.
Halimbawa, pag dito ko din drawing.
Dalawa din.
Okay, how about halimbawa sa dulong dulo ako nag-drawing?
Wala.
Isa na lang, di ba?
Isa lang.
That's correct. One lang. Kaso class, basta merong kang vertical line na nagdalawang points, hindi na siya function. Okay, so B is not a function. Letter C. C. Kahit saan ka mag-drawing dyan, kahit ilang vertical ang gawin mo.
Function yun, sir.
Function. And letter D.
Function.
Parabola.
Not a function.
Si parabola.
Not a function,
not,
sir.
Not a function.
Not
a function.
Letter D is not a function.
Not a function.
So functions, so kanina, nakita natin, meron tayong ordered pairs, meron tayong table, meron tayong diagram, at meron tayong graph. Okay? Para ma-identify natin which of which is a function. Pero functions as representations of real life situations can be like this. Monogamous marriage. What do you mean by monogamous marriage? Yung isahan lang mag-asawa. Sa Christian, sa Catholic, kapag nag-asawa ka, di ba, ang pinaka-legal lang talaga, isa lang. Hindi pwedeng dalawa. So, si lalaki para sa isang babae. Monogamous marriage. Siyempre, iba yung legal wives. Sa legal wives,
pwede lima, sir.
Sino yung bida doon?
Dennis Trillo.
Anong pangalan niya?
Andrea Torres.
Dennis Trillo po. Tsaka si, ano?
O'Malley.
Matthew Gale.
Ismael, sir.
Sunod niya kayo. Very good. So, si Dennis Trillo, para kay Bianca, para kay
Andrea.
Alice Dixon, para kay, sino pa yung isa?
Andrea Torres.
Okay. So, isang lalaki para sa tatlo. Naulit si lalaki para sa tatlo. So, pag Islam marriage is not function.
Function.
It will not function. Naintindihan ba yung function?
Apo.
A function. A relation can be function if it's one-to-one relationship. Okay? So I hope in real life situations, mas na-get ninyo kung anong relation ang function. Ang magfa-function. Like monogamous marriage. Nationality. Is this a function?
Depende, sir.
Yes po.
No, sir.
No.
Okay, depende.
Depende, sir.
Okay, sumagot ng depende.
Ako, sir.
Isang tao, mag-dual citizen. Siya ay Pilipino, siya ay Amerikano. Isang tao lang. But, pero mas marami pa rin na ang nationality ay iisa. Kaya, in general, nationality is a function. Because isang tao, isang nationality. In general. Okay? Ibang case yung dual citizen. Okay? How about religion?
Of course, function.
Yes, very good. It's a function. Kasi si Juan ay isang Katoliko. Hindi pwede si Juan magpabautismo sa ibang sekta. Hindi magpo-function. Did you get it?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. So
these are functions.
Yes.
Now, another function we have is a piecewise function. It is a function in which more than one formula is used to determine the output. So each formula has its own domain. And the domain of the function is the union of all these similar domains. So we notate this idea like this. Gaya ng nakikita nyo. Okay, so you have the function f of x is equal to, we have three formulas. So ganyan yung tinatawag nating piecewise function. Kung titingnan nyo siya sa graph class, sa graph, hindi ko na ilagay dito. Sa graph, kung titingnan nyo siya, putol-putol siya. Marami kang makikitang sa isang Cartesian plane, marami kang makikitang drawing, graph. Okay? Dalawa, tatlo, like that. Okay, so look at these examples. A user is charged 250 monthly for a particular mobile plan, which includes 200 free text messages. Messages in excess of 200 are charged 1 peso. So pag lumagpas ka ng 200, may additional ng 1 peso each. Represent the monthly cost for text messaging using the function PM, where M is the number of messages sent in a month. So paano natin siya i-represent as a piecewise function? So like this. So we have the function P of M is equal to 250 if 0 is less than M, is less than or equal to 200. If you are sending messages not exceeding 200. Okay, class, itong answer na to, dahil ito yung example, pinapakita ko kung paano igawin. Pero ang totoo, ito lang talaga ang ipapakita sa inyo, itong problem na to, and then you have to find the answer. You should know how to write this piecewise function notation. Okay, so again, 250 if your messages is between 0 to 200. From 0, less than M, less than equal to 200. Messages not exceeding 200. Now, messages in excess of 200 are charged 1 pesos. 1 peso each. So 250 plus M, if M is greater than 200. So ibig sabihin ito, itong M na to, magdadagdag ka ng piso. If your M is greater than 200. Pag lumagpas ka ng 200 sa free text messages. Is that clear? In case the messages sent were more than 200.
Okay.
Letter B. Meron pa yatang pumapasok ha. Sandali ha. Dapat hindi na to tinatanggap eh. Tagasan kaya to? Okay. Next time class, bawal malate ha. Uy! Next time, bawal malate ha. Tsaka si Ocon. Ocon, next time, bawal malate ha.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let's continue. Okay, letter B. Nakikita ba?
Oh, sir.
Yes, sir.
A certain chocolate bar costs 50 pesos per piece. However, if you buy more than 5 pieces, they will mark down the price to 48 per piece. Kung 5 pieces ang bibili nyo. Use a piecewise function to represent the cost in terms of the number of chocolate bars bought. So, kunyari, hindi nakikita to. Okay, kaya lang, nadyan na siya. F of N is equal to 50 pesos. Okay? If 0 less than N less than equal to 5. Ang ibig sabihin nito? For buying 5 chocolate bars or less, halagang 50 pesos siya if ang chocolate na bibili nyo ay 5 pesos. Okay? Between 0 to 5. Now, kung greater than 5, N is greater than 5, then you have to pay 48 pesos. Times N. Bakit may N dito? The number of pieces. Okay, or the number of pieces. So, medyo balikan nyo to kung nalilito kayo, ha? Okay. Now, evaluating a function. In evaluating function, it's a process of determining the value of the function at the number assigned to a given variable. Just like in evaluating algebraic expressions, to evaluate function, you just need to replace each letter in the expression with the assigned value and error B, perform the operations in the expressions using the correct order of operations. So let's have an example. Given the function f of x is equal to 2x minus 4, find the value of the function if x is equal to 3. You just have to plug in the value x is equal to 3. Plug it in your equation, in your function, I mean. Okay, you just plug it here. if you put it here, 2 times 3 is 6, 6 minus 4 is 2. Therefore, the value, when you evaluate your function, 2x minus 4 is 2. Very elementary. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Number 2. If your function is 3x squared plus 7, find g of negative 3. Or just substitute negative 3 to your x. Okay? You just substitute it here. Plug it here. So 3 times negative 3 power 2 is 9. 3 times 9 is 27 plus 7, 34. Easy. Number 3. Given this function, what kind of function is this? Can you tell me?
Quadratic function.
Very good. Who's that?
Juris.
Surname.
Sir. Dumaas.
From?
From ABMA.
Okay, good. From ABMA, Miss Dumaas. This is a quadratic function, correct? Because the highest degree that you can see in your equation is 2. If you have 2 as the highest exponent, it means quadratic. Anong itsura ng function na to? If you graph this.
Parabola, sir.
Very good. This is parabola. Okay?
Ang galing.
So find P is 0 and P is negative 1. Dalawa ang pinapahanap last. P is 0, substitute in your X. And P is negative 1, substitute in your X. So unahin natin yung P is 0. If P is 0, so X daw ay 0. 0 square is 0. 0, negative 2. 0 times 3 is 0. 0, the answer is negative 2. Okay? If P is 0. Now, if P is 1, sorry class, this is not 0. This is negative 1. Correction? This is negative 1. So, lahat ng X, negative 1. Negative 1 square is 1. 3 times 1 is 3. 5 times negative 1 is negative 5. Minus 2. 3 minus 5 minus 2 is negative 4. Therefore, P negative 1 is negative 4. That is the answer. Number 4. Given this function, what kind of function is this? 5x plus 1. Sige, si Dumaas ulit.
Linear function, sir.
Very good. This is a linear function. If you graph this, obviously, linear, it's a line. You will see a line. It's not a parabola. It's a line. So find f of h plus 1. So, ibig sabihin, class, this is the value, h plus 1. You have to plug this to your x. Plug this to your x. 5h plus 1 plus 1. So, 5, distributive property, 5 times h, 5h. 5 times 1, 5. 5 plus 1, 6. Therefore, this is, if f h plus 1 will become 5h plus 6. The answer is this. Okay? Wala tayong value kasi ang hinahanap natin, f of h plus 1 eh. So kung ano yung value dito, yun ang lalagay nyo dito. Clear? Number 5. Given g of x is equal to root of 3x minus 2, find g of 9. Find g of 9. So si 9, lalagay natin sa x. E times 9, 27 minus 2, 25. Root of 5, sorry, root of 25 is 5. Therefore, the answer is 5. Okay? Okay, now, for the activity class, this is your work. This is what I need. The output from the activity or activities. For activity 1, just answer this one. Nasa lip nyo rin to, class. Nasa lip. So, hindi ko na kayo tutulungan dito. Just review or replay ninyo itong recorded video na to para maalala nyo kung paano nga sagutan to. Ano ilalagay natin? Sige, sagutan ko yung number 1. Okay. A tricycle ride costs 10 pesos for the first 2 kilometers. Additional kilometer adds 8 pesos. Okay. Siguro naman nagta-tricycle kayo, no? Kapag more than 2 kilometers daw, based on the problem, mag-add ka na ng 8 pesos. Use a piecewise function to represent the tricycle fare in terms of distance, D in kilometers. So 10 pesos if Ano ilalagay nyo rito?
To kailangan ito.
D. Ilalagay nyo muna yung D. D is less than or
equal. Less than 2.
Less than or equal to 2. Okay, so dito, D is less than or equal to 2. How about this?
8.
10 plus 8.
Ano na? Kapag 10 kilometers na. 10 plus D. Medyo tama. Medyo tama.
10 plus 8 po, sir.
Tapos, medyo tama ulit. Pagsamahin niyo yun.
10 plus 8, open parenthesis D, close parenthesis po, sir.
Very good. Who's that?
Benzer Kulagbang po.
From
STEM C.
Okay, good. STEM C.
Nice one.
Okay. So, ang sagot dito, 10 plus 8 times D. 10 plus 8 times D. Ito times sa D kasi hindi nyo alam kung ilang kilometers na ang na-use. Pwedeng 3, 4, 5, 6, higher than 3. Equal or higher than 3. So, 10 plus 8 times D. So, number 3, that will be yours. Hindi ko na kayo tutulungan dyan. That's activity 1. For activity 2, I want you to analyze the following functions by evaluating its value. Write true if. Write true if the indicated answer and solution is correct. Class, sorry ah, yung lip ninyo, mali. Kulang. Hindi ko alam kung paano ko maiko-correct yung mga PMDL. Pero dahil narito kayo ngayon sa klasiko, kung PMDL ka, DMDL, ODL, ito yung correct, corrected, ano, copy. So dapat ganito. Kulang kasi yung nasa lip copy nyo. So if not, rewrite the solution here to arrive with the correct answer on the space provided. So let's try to evaluate. Kapag true to, sabihin nyo lang true. Okay. The f of t is equal to 2t minus 3. Find f t square. Anong gagawin natin dito? This t square is a substitute natin kay t. Okay, so meaning t square lalagyan natin dito. 2t square minus 3. 2t square minus 3. Is that correct or wrong?
Correct, sir.
That is correct. So ilalagay nyo lang dito, true. Okay? True. Bonus na naman yan. Dapat ang activity kayo ang sumasagot. Number 2, ganun din. O, ito yung problem natin. Tingnan nyo mabuti. Kung may mali, ilagay nyo, i-correct nyo siya dito. Tingin ko, mukhang hindi lang na-simplify ito. Lagay nyo yung tamang solution and answer over here. Number 3, given the function, this is 5x minus 7 over 3x minus 2, fine. O, yan. Lalagay natin si negative 3 in your x's. Yan, 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 yan. Is that correct? And then kung true, ilagay nyo true. If not, ilagay yung tamang sagot. Number, same with number 4 and number 5 before your activity. Okay? And then to finish the Tuesday activity, I want you to answer in your LEAP the assimilation, assessment, and reflection section of the LEAP. Assimilation, assessment, ito yung 10 multiple choice questions. And multiple choice question. Reflection, madali lang naman yung reflection. Okay? So, that's it for Tuesday. Pero dahil ginaganahan ako, itutuloy ko na ang Thursday. Class, isang beses lang ako magka-classes every Tuesday lang. Sasama ko na to. Okay? Let's try this one. Okay? Ano na tayo? Moving forward, secret message for Thursday to, ah. Answer each question by matching column A with column B. Write the letter of the correct answer at the blank before each number. Ang LEAP nyo dapat pang Thursday na. Day 2 Thursday. Day 2 Thursday. Okay, week number 1, day 2 Thursday. So class, bubuin nyo lang yung secret message dyan. Review lang ito, review. Ang karaniwan ng introductory part ng isang lesson ay review. So, tingnan natin. Marunong ba kayo mag-LCD? 1/3 and 2 over 7. What's the LCD?
21. 14.
14,
sir.
Ano? 14.
21,
21. Okay, that's the least common denominator. Pero class, find the tawag dito. May mali sa question eh. Not really the denominator lang ang hanapin natin, class. Okay? 1/3 and 2/7. That is this one.
I.
12.
I. So, ibig sabihin, yung number 1, answer sa number 1 ay I. Nasaan ang number 1 dito? Si Ben, I ang ilalagay dito. I. Meron pa bang number 1? Wala na.
Meron.
Wala na. Wala na akong nakikita ng number 1. No?
Wala na.
So, ito lang ang lalagay nyo ng I. Okay? How about let's try number 13. Let's try number 13. How to factor out this? What's the answer?
Yes, sir.
Can you factor out x squared minus 8x plus 15?
There are some. X minus 3 and X minus 5.
Very good. X minus 3, X minus 5. Or this one. Okay? X minus 5, X minus 3. So number 13 is O. Palagyan nyo rito. O. Meron pa ba? Ito. O. Ano pa? Ito. O. 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 Tapusin nyo yung 1 to 17 and tell me, sagutan nyo to, secret message, anong sagot dyan? Right? Okay, let's start now. That's just what do you call that? A review. So definition, let f and g be functions. So number one, their sum denoted by f plus g is the function denoted by, tandaan nyo to class, f plus g of x. That's how you read it. F plus g of x is equal to f of x plus g of x. Their difference, denoted by f minus g, is the function denoted by f minus g of x equals f of x minus g of x. And their product, denoted by f times g, is the function denoted by f times g of x equals f of x times g of x, etc., etc. Number 5, composite function, f composed of g of x. I repeat. How do you read this? Not f times g, huh? No. F composed of g. F composed of g of x. Pwede rin natin siyang sabihin f of g of x. Pares lang tong dalawa. That's how you read it. F of g of x. F composed of g of x. Okay? So, ganun yung siyang basahin. Example. Given the functions, how many functions do we have? We have 3 functions, f of x, g of x, h of x. We have to determine the following functions. F plus g of x, f minus g of x, plus minus times divide, tapos plus minus times divide. Parehas lang, kaya lang this one is x, this one is 3. So we will see the difference. We need this given, the given functions. How many functions? 1, 2, 3. We need it. So ito yung sasagutan natin. Okay? Solution. Ito yung unang problem, f plus g of x. Ano nga yung given natin? Ito yung given natin. So, f plus g. So, ibig sabihin, si f of x plus g of x. F of x, ayun. G of x, ayun. So, x plus 5 plus 2x minus 1. Simply add 2x plus x is 3x. 5 plus negative 1 is 4. So, 3x plus 4. Same with b, subtraction. F of x, ito. G of x, ito. Subtract nyo si f minus g. So, ito minus ito. X minus 2x, negative x. 5 minus negative 1. 5 minus negative 1. Change natin to. Change natin ng sign. Minus minus become plus. O kami nagtatanong paano naging plus. Minus minus it becomes plus. 5 plus 1, 6. The answer is negative x plus 6. Multiplication. Multiply lang natin itong dalawang function na to. X plus 5 tsaka 2x minus 1. Si f of x tsaka si g of x. Distributive property and you will come up with this. And letter D, division. O si hx. Ito si hx. This is the function, quadratic function, over g of x. Ito. So 2x squared, si hx, over 2x minus 1, si gx. Factor out 2x squared plus 9x minus 5 will give you x plus 5 plus x plus 5 times 2x minus 1. Since we have 2x minus 1, we can cancel out these two terms. Cancel out. What remains is x plus 5. Clear? Next. Letter G. Okay. Ito yung given natin, x plus 5. Okay. Paano na natin gagawin yan? So, pwede natin gawin ganito, class. Yung sa F, since 3 siya, kasi ito yung hinahanap po, F plus G of 3. F plus G of 3. If F is 3, o di substitute natin sa function x plus 5, 8. G of 3, 2x minus 1 times 3, 2 times 3, 6 minus 1, 5. So, we have F of 3, G of 3, 3 plus 8 plus 5, will give you 13. Okay, that's how you do it. Okay? Or let's see a machine function. This is a machine function. Same problem lang to, class. Ito pa rin yung functions natin, x plus 5 to x minus 1. Diba? Pag in-add natin siya, at ang value ng 3, this is a machine function, addition. 3, ipasok nyo sa machine, and the machine will evaluate x plus 5. So, 3 plus 5 will give you 8. Okay? How about sa G? 3 times 2 is 6 minus 1 will give you 5. So 8 plus 5 is 13. Nakuha? Diba? Or,
nakuha,
x plus 2x is 3x. 5 plus negative 1 is 4. Pero G, ang 3 ang hinahanap natin. Ipasok natin si 3 sa function. 3 times 9. 3 times 3 is 9, plus 4 is 13. So, ganun din. Okay? 8 plus 5 is 13. 3 times 3, 9, plus 4, 13. This is a machine function. Same with subtraction. Look at the function. Diba 8 na nga to? Diba 5 na nga to? 8 minus 5 is 3. Ito naman ang gawin natin. X minus 2X, negative X. 5 minus negative 1, 6. Ipasok natin si 3. Dahil yun ang hinahanap. 3, negative 3, plus 6, 3. The answer is 3. Same with multiplication. Multiply this function. Multiply this function, x plus 5 to x minus 1, will give you this. Sagutan na natin siya eh. Okay. Or, ilagay na natin si 3, pasok natin siya sa machine, 8. Pasok natin siya sa machine, 5. 8 times 5, 40. Or kung ito ang gagamitin natin, 3 times, or 3 squared is 6 times 2. Sorry, 3 squared is 9 times 2, 18. Plus, 9 times 3, 27. 27 plus 18 is 45. Minus 5 is 40. Easy. And for the division, itong function na to, i-divide natin dito. Di ba nag-cancel-cancel na tayo kanina? Dito yan, no? Yeah? Mm-hmm. Oh, nag-cancel-cancel tayo, di ba? Ito na lang yung natira. Kasi h divided, function h divided by g. X plus 5. So, sa division, ayan na nga. Divide natin, will give you x plus 5. So, pasok natin si 3, 3 plus 5, 8. Or, pasok natin si 3 dito, then process will give you 40. Pasok natin si 3, process 5. 40 divided by 5 is 8. Easy. Now, malapit tayo matapos. Composition of functions. So in composition of function, we will have a lot of substitution. You learned in previous lesson that to evaluate a function, you will just substitute a certain number in all of the variables in the given function. Similarly, if the function is substituted to all variables in another function, you are performing a composition of functions to create another function. So some authors call this operation as function of functions. Okay? Function of functions. Let's have an example. given this function, a quadratic function, and this function, a linear function, find the following. Find A, find B, find C. Paano nga basahin to, anyone? Hindi times, ha? Hindi F times H. Circle to. Literally, you can read this as
compose.
F circle H.
Compose.
Literally, ha? F circle H. Pero hindi yun yung sinabi ko kanina. Ito ay F.
F of H of X.
Okay. Or di kaya, F of H of X. F compose H of 4. Or F of H of 4. Pero see, H compose F of X. Or H of F of X. Ganun yung pagbasa na. Let's start. So pag ganyan class, this can be written like this, F of H of X. So si X muna. Okay? Tingnan natin. Paano siya gawin? Si H, function H. Si function H daw ay ilalagay natin sa machine na F. Makuha niya? Ganun yung compose. Pag ganito ang base niyan, pag ganyan, pabaligtad. So let's start with function H. Papasok natin siya kay F. Okay? So what is function H? Ito, X plus 2. Okay? So X plus 2. F, X plus 2. But since our function F is this, so meaning this X plus 2 will be placed to all the X's. This one and this one. So ito, palit nyo rito. Ito, palit nyo rito. Will become like this. X plus 2 squared plus 5, X plus 2 plus 6. Okay, and then do simple algebra, expand this, distribute this, plus 6. So when you expand this, we'll give you x squared plus 4x plus 4. And then distribute this, we'll give you 5x plus 10 plus 6. The final answer, when you combine all the similar terms, will give you x squared plus 9x. 9x kasi 4x and 5x. Plus 20, bakit 4, 10, 6, 20. So this is our final answer for the problem F compose H of X. Okay? Ulitin ko, si H, papasok natin sa machine na F. Ito si H, ano ba si F? Ito si F. Kaya papasok natin siya sa lahat ng X. Number 2, pair B. Tandaan niyo yung sagot na to, ha? Kasi mukhang parehas, oh. Oh, diba? So kung ano man yung F of F compose of H, papalitan lang natin siya ng 4 dito. Yan. Sa machine natin, pag pinasok mo itong si H kay F, substitute X plus 2 in all the X. Okay? We'll give you this. This is the output for the F compose of H of X. So X squared plus 9X plus 20. Tandaan nyo ito. X squared plus 9X plus 20. Tingnan nyo ito. Pair B. Okay, in-evaluate niyo muna si H. This is the first way of how to solve it is this one. The second way is like this. The machine function. Pero kung ito naman ang gusto niyo, pwede rin. Let's try. Evaluate H of 4. O substitute natin si 4 kay H. Ano ba yung function H? X plus 2. 6. And then step 2, F of 6. Diba? F of 6. Saan galing si 6? Kay H. Ipapasok na natin si 6 kay F. That's why it will become 6 squared plus 30 plus 6 will give you 72. So 72. Now, the final answer is 72. Tingnan nyo dito. 4 kay H. Bibigay niya si 6. Si 6, ipapasok ko siya sa F, will give you 72. Clear? Letter C, wala na. Okay, activity na. Ganun lang pala kadali yun. Okay. Sa LEAP ninyo, ito yung activity ninyo sa LEAP. Sa hard copy ninyo. Let P of X is equal to this. Another function equals to this. And another function equals to this. Find M minus P of X. P of 5 plus M of 3 minus H of 1, M of X over P of X, P of X plus 1, and P of 3 minus 3 of M of 2. 3 composed of M composed of 2. Alright, and letters number 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, it's all written there, nasa lip ninyo. Sasagutan nyo lang yan. Okay, so answer the assimilation, assessment, and reflection section of the lip. Day 2, Thursday. Tapos na ba tayo? That's all.
Question? Thank you po, sir.
Thank you, sir.
None po.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you po, sir.
Okay. Walang
thank you po.
Wait
thank you,
lang,
po,
ha? Sir. Wait lang. Hold on. Magkaroon pa tayong documentation. Before you leave, please turn on your cameras or some documentation.